हेलो स्टैंडर्ड 10, वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर क्लास। हाँ वेल, दिस इज चैप्टर 7 पार्ट 1। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज फंक्शंस इन कैलसी। ओके चिल्ड्रन, इन चैप्टर 6 ऑल पार्ट्स वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट the introduction of calci, we have seen the different features of calci. We have seen, as we know, calci is similar to MS Excel, whereas in open office it is calci. Working of both the things or both the packages, either calci or Excel, are totally same. Only the difference is one is proprietary, that is copyrighted, and one is totally open source. Okay, calci is open source, whereas that MS Excel is copyrighted. So let's start functions in calci. Children, as I told, it is open office program. Fine. So here you can see open office has its different features, text, then spreadsheet. So calci is spreadsheet. Or we can say the spreadsheet program is called calci in OpenOffice. Rest other features are there. Presentation, that is PowerPoint. Then we are having here different database, that is base, drawing wall, you know, and formula is for maths. Okay. Now we go to OpenOffice.org calci. It is a spreadsheet program licensed under the GNU project, and it is installed with functions which are more comprehensive and are easy to use. Features of calci: it is easier to pull in a raw data, in raw data from corporate databases, cross tabulate, summarize and convert it into the meaningful information. Natural language allows the user to make formulas using words, right? Some buttons automatically insert some function. Wizard help in picking up, utilizing the functions in the spreadsheet as well as in downloading the available templates. Scenario manager in calci allows the user to use what if analysis, that is comparing profitability of high, medium, low sales forecast. Styles and formatting features of calci allows the user to manipulate the elements, such as putting background, choosing fonts, putting borders, etc. etc. Open document saving enables the user to access the created spreadsheet under the other open document compliant software. It enables sharing through multiple user support children. So these were the different features of calci, OpenOffice calci. Well, entering only data and simple mathematical expressions may not be sufficient for real life applications involving complex decisions, making operations and analyzing large amount of data. To carry out such activities, spreadsheet programs such as calci provide built-in standard functions for mathematical, logical, statistical, date and time, financial and other calculations on numbers and text. A function, as we are studying about in this chapter about functions, children, so a function like an expression generally begins with an equal sign followed by a function name and one or more function argument specified in its brackets. Sometimes operators such as plus may also be used with functions in formulas. However, it is common practice to use equals to symbol as a prefix to avoid a function being simple text. That equals tells the calci it's a function. Okay, that's why it's a prefix to avoid a function being simple text. The arguments can be a value, an address of a cell, text, a constant, or a one or more function. In chapter 5, we have used the sum function from the toolbar, shopping bill example. Sum function directly applied from the toolbar indicated by symbol sigma. Okay, children. It's a short kind of shortcut. Systematically, the same function can be written as is equals to sum a1 to a10, where sum is the name of the function, which is specified the summation or addition procedure is called n, and a1 and a10 are references to the Kelsey cells in the same worksheet. Together, a1 to a10 specify the range of cells containing 10 different cells. The content written in these brackets is known as argument of the function. Instead of a cell address or cell range, we can also write values as sum 23, 25. Okay, children, hope you got it. You must have done this also in 9th standard, right? Similarly, you may also wish to try is equals to sum a1 to a10 function using comma or semicolon, right? Instead of colon in between the cell address a1 and a10. You may observe that just by using comma or semicolon, one can sum up the two values and the cell at the cell a1 and a10 respectively. To sum all the values a1 and a10 content within them semicolon, we must use either colon or individually all cells. Understood, children? Colon is used for a1 to a10, the values between a1 to a10. Comma or semicolon is used a1 and a10. Understood, children, the difference? So illustrate the three ways of performing addition operation. You can see the status of selected cell having value sum is equals to 55, and the formula bar showing full summation expression. You can also see when a1 is referred in formula, its color is blue as shown in figure 7.1, and the color of cell a1 is also blue. This is clearly useful to cross check the entered formula. Hame ye batata hai jo formula humne entered kiya hai uska उस सेल का कलर जो है वो ब्लू रहता है. सो वी कैन क्रॉस चेक कि करेक्ट है कि नहीं. द प्रोसेस ऑफ इंसर्टिंग फंक्शन इज सिमिलर फॉर ऑल फंक्शन. सो द आर्ग्यूमेंट स्पेसिफिक टू द फंक्शन एंड द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग ऑफ द फंक्शंस आर मैंडेटरी. दैट इज टू यूज अ फंक्शन वी नीड टू एंटर अ करेक्ट स्पेलिंग ऑफ द फंक्शन अलोंग विद नेसेसरी आर्ग्यूमेंट. अगर आप सम फंक्शन यूज करें तो यू हैव टू यूज द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग. इट्स नॉट एस ए एम और एस ओ एम. ओके, इट्स एस यू एम. दिस इज नोन एज सिंटैक्स ऑफ द फंक्शन. इफ यू डू नॉट नो द एग्जैक्ट स्पेलिंग ऑफ अ फंक्शन एंड द पॉसिबल एट्रीब्यूट्स, इट विल रिजल्ट इन एरर. सो यू कैन सी चिल्ड्रन हियर इज इक्वल्स टू सम इन द ब्रैकेट अलोंग विद कॉमा ईच after each argument. Fine, children? Either you have these three methods of using sigma. This is the sigma symbol. Yeah, auto sum. Then either you can take sum a1 colon a10. Right? a1 se lekar a10 tak ye pura. Ya to fir aap le sakte hain sum इज इक्वल्स टू सम a1 a2, क्योंकि a1 और a2 कनेक्ट हो रहा है, a2 और a3, इसलिए हमने कॉमा दिया. बीच में हम सेमीकॉलन भी दे सकते हैं, लेकिन फुल रेंज देने के लिए फुल वी आर यूजिंग व्हाट? कॉलन. ओके, हियर द डिटेल्स एज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड इज गिवन फॉर हियर. एंटरिंग ओनली डेटा एंड सिंपल मैथमेटिकल एक्सप्रेशन may not be sufficient for real life application involving complex decision making operation and analyzing large amount of data. So to carry out such activities, spreadsheet programs such as Kelsey provide built-in standard functions. Kelsey has its own built-in functions which are called standard functions. Which standard functions we are going to see in this session? spreadsheet package provides various functions for such purpose. Which of the functions are there in your course are as under? First, mathematical, second, logical, statistical, date and time, financial, text-based. Let's see the again, a little recap. Function like an expression generally begins with equals sign, followed by a function name, one or more function argument in its brackets. Compulsory to use equals symbol as prefix to avoid function being a simple text. The argument can be a value, a cell address, text, constant or function. The sum function directly applied from the toolbar using sigma or autosum is a shortcut for sum. Systematically, the same function can be written as we have seen earlier, children, same way. Name of the function A1 to A10 are the references known as cell address. Together, A1 and A10 specify the range containing the 10 different cells. Content written in the bracket is known as argument of the function. Instead of cell range, we can also write cell address by applying. Okay, children. As we have seen earlier, three different methods of using sum or adding data, adding numbers, right? Function wizard, let's see. It's not possible to place many functions on the toolbar or remember them with their correct syntax. Hence, most of the functions are entered through function wizard. To open function wizard, children, autosum ki tarah hum bahut sare functions ko toolbar pe nahi rakh sakte. Isliye hamare paas Kelsey ne hume ek function wizard diya hai. Function wizard operate karne ke liye, we will go to insert menu. In insert, we will go to function. Ya to fir control or F2 dono ki saath mein. Right? And it will open function wizard. Okay? Let's see. See, children? Going to insert menu. In insert, we click on function option. Now, this will open insert function. You can say insert function wizard. Search for the function. Aapko jis bhi function ke liye kaam karna hai, aap use yahan type kijiye. Okay, category you can use from here, mathematical, engineer, logical, statistical, jo bhi category hamari hai. Ab yahan se we will select a function. Us category ka function we will have. Sum is the first function. Okay, we are getting it, children. You must have seen earlier in previous classes or previous standards. This is the sum function auto in this toolbar. Fine, children, we are having sum function. Okay, different other functions are also there. Average, count, max, minimum. So here we are having sum. In function wizard, insert function, in function menu. Here we are having sum toolbar. Got it, students? You can see this, children. Many of the functions are displayed over here. Insert function, autosum, recently used functions, financial, logical, textual, date and time, lookup and references, mathematical and trigonometry, and more functions. Okay. Here we are selecting, let's say, financial, or we are selecting category for function. We are selecting the function name count if. Got it? Let's go to mathematical functions. Math functions are very helpful when we work with numbers in Kelsey. There are numbers of functions related to maths from which you are taught the most common one and useful one. Then we are having absolute values of number, the ABS function, that removes the minus sign from a negative number and makes the number positive. It does nothing on zero or positive number. The syntax is equals to ABS. N is to what argument, whereas N is a number. ABS function is very helpful when we want only positive number in output. Consider that you are using an expression within another expression. The CALCI first calculates inner expressions and uses the inner expression value as argument of the outer expression. But the outer expressions such as square root allow only non-negative values. What if the inner expression returns a negative value? The negative value of the inner expression makes the outer expression invalid. You can see, children, here ABS function is used on screen. Value f of n is minus 19. We are using on this B1. B is the cell name and where the value is given, that is on first row. So B1, ABS B1, in bracket we are putting B1. Here we have to write is equals to symbol. Okay, output is what? 19. Got it, children? Minus 19 is the positive value convert. Now, the exponential function. The exp function returns the value of exponential, that is for given number, where e is approximately equals to. You can see, children, here. Next, we are having natural logarithm. The ln function returns the value of natural logarithm, that is base of e for the given positive number. The syntax is ln number, where n is positive number. For example, if we write is equals to ln 8, in a cell, it will return the output given like this. Logarithm base 10 returns the value of logarithm base 10 for the given positive number. The syntax is log n, where n is the positive number. Now, power functions returns the number raised to the given. The syntax is power, number and the power. For example, power 210, the output will be 1024. Here it is given, children. Value of n, that is number 2, value of power 10 is equals to power 210, output is given. Value of 2, but power is 1, so 2 into 1 is 2. Value of number is 2, power is 2, output is 4, power is 3, output is 8, power is 4, output is 16, and so on till 10th power, output is 1024. I hope you got it, children. Now, factorial function. The fact functions returns a value of factorial function for the given number. Product of all integers from 1 to given number, say n. The syntax is fact n or number, where n is integer number, right? For example, if we write is equals to fact 3, the CALCI will consider this as an expression 1 into 2 into 3 and returns 6. Here, fact is, number is 5, so we are taking fact B1, output is 120. 3, 2, right? 5 into 4 into 3 into 1. So, children, we will continue in the next session. Till then, thank you. See you next session, children. I hope you understood. Please have the help of your textbook while watching this video. Thank you, children. Have a good day. See you in next session.